Hi folks, and welcome to Adiga Armory. Today we'll be taking a look at some fresh data on gun ownership in America. An article published by the Washington Examiner references newly released federal data from the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives showing that the number of guns in private hands is tens of millions of units higher than previous estimates. For several years now, it's been assumed that roughly 350 to 400 million guns are privately owned in the U.S. However, new data indicates that this number is actually closer to 423 million, a whopping 23 to 73 million more than previously estimated. That is almost 100 times the number of small arms weapons currently owned by the U.S. Armed Forces. That said, it's probably safe to assume that the threat of firearm confiscation coming from some of our political leaders would prove a bit more daunting than they may have initially anticipated. And to that we say, God bless America and long live the Constitution. With all those snazzy new guns out there, please remember to exercise common sense gun control by gripping the gun firmly with both hands at all times. And of course, remember to keep those guns in proper, serviceable condition with our ultra-premium, battle-ready, citrus-powered synthetic CLP. It'll have your guns running longer and harder than a well-oiled adult film star. According to the NSSF, these figures show that America has a strong desire to continue to purchase firearms for lawful purposes. In further dissecting this new data, the NSSF determined that more than half, or 54% of all rifles produced in 2017 were classified as semi-automatic, centerfire, modern sporting rifles such as AR-15s and AK-47s, or as some would like to call them, big, black, scary-looking, belt-clip-fed, 30mm automatic, high-powered, military-style assault weapons of death. The data indicates that there are over 17.7 million of these types of rifles in private hands. And there's over a million more being purchased each year. And according to the FBI Expanded Crime Database, less than 300 homicides are committed nationwide using all types of rifles. If we assume that of those rifle deaths, slightly over half are done with a scary black rifle like this one, that means less than 1 out of 118,000 scary black rifles end up actually being used in a homicide. That's less than 0.0009%, folks. Yes, you heard that right. Less than 0.9 of 1% of the scary black rifles in America are actually used in a homicide each year.
Okay, hold on a sec. Time out. Didn't the fact-checking truth masters at Snopes complain about using that number for rifle deaths since about 3,000 firearm homicides do not specify the type of firearm used? Well, in that case, let's humor them by adding in the prorated amount of that to our figures. In the most recent data we have available, firearm homicides were distributed accordingly. Of the 11,004 total gun homicides, minus the 3,077 unknown gun types, we have 7,927 known gun type homicides in 2016. Of that figure, 7,105 are handguns, which is about 89.6% of all gun homicides. So our adjusted total for handgun homicides would come to about 9,862. Looks pretty bad for handguns, but In their defense, they are used much more often to save lives and stop crime than any other gun type due to the fact that you might actually have one on you when you need it. But I digress. If we were to apply the same math logic to rifles, we would get an additional 144 rifle homicides, or 519 total, based on the abnormally high 2016 numbers. This still only amounts to 4.7% of the total gun homicides, and it includes all rifles. If we generously assume that half are done using scary black rifles, it is still less than 2.4% of all gun homicides. Furthermore, if we look at that number as a portion of all scary black rifles owned by American civilians, it still amounts to only 0.0014%, or 1.4 thousandths of 1% being used each year in a homicide. So I really have to ask Snopes, by using the quote of the sage, what difference at this point does it make? We may as well argue over whether quarks are smaller than neutrinos, when they're both so minuscule they can hardly be observed.
To put all that into perspective, according to the aforementioned FBI crime database, nearly four times as many people were killed with blunt objects like hammers and clubs, and nearly 10 times as many people are killed with knives or other edged weapons. Furthermore, if we compare the small number of black rifle deaths to the hundreds of millions of people who have perished in recent times at the hands of their own government, the disparity grows even deeper. Anyway, don't we have much more imminent threats to life and limb than scary black rifles? Or any guns for that matter. A recent study conducted by Johns Hopkins University found that over 251,000 people die each year in the U.S. as a result of preventable medical mistakes. That's over 9.5% of all of the deaths in the U.S. annually, and it amounts to almost 1,000 times more deaths than all rifle homicides combined. Yes, 1,000 times more. Another really interesting aspect of the recent BATFE data dump is the amazing amount of ammo being produced and distributed in the USA. Our bold and industrious ammo factories pumped out an epic 8.1 billion rounds of ammo in all shapes and sizes in 2018 alone. And that was just for the US market. That said, it is very nice to finally get a decent selection of 22 bulk packs on the shelf after the painful and destitute famines of yesteryear. This new data shows us what many of us already knew, that the overwhelming majority of American gun owners are peaceful individuals who use firearms for legitimate purposes. Considering that firearms, including these scary black rifles, are used millions of times each year to save lives, stop crimes, defend innocent people, and most importantly, to keep our own government from totally owning us. You have to ask this. How many people would have died had the gun control advocates gotten what they wanted? And it leaves us to wonder, why is so much energy being expended on disarming law-abiding Americans under the guise of public safety? After all, if our leaders were genuinely concerned about our safety, wouldn't the conversation be about banning these deadly gun-free zones in which over 90% of mass shootings occur? Or perhaps allowing nationwide constitutional carry as a first line of defense against violent maniacs? Instead, the conversation is about declawing the entire U.S. population while our masters enjoy being surrounded by an armed militia of their own. And at our expense, no less. And with that, we want to thank you for visiting us today. Please remember to give us a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. And we'll see you again next time at Adiga Armory.